A TSBVI outreach tutorial. APH graphic aid for mathematics, aka graph board. Part 1, an introduction of the various boards. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas school for the blind and visually impaired outreach math consultant.
I would like to introduce you to the APH graphic aid for mathematics. APH stands for American Printing House for the Blind. So the official title of this tool is the APH graphic aid for mathematics. As I mentioned, it is available from APH on federal quota funds, and if you are interested in ordering one, I would refer you to their website, which is www.aph.org, or you could call them at 800-223-1839. It consists of a cork board mounted with a rubber mat embossed with a 34 by 30 grid of 1/2 inch squares. It's also supplied with the following, which are in this long cylindrical tube. When you get your box, be sure that you don't lose this. I find that a lot of people don't realize it's in there, throw the box away, and have thrown away all the accessories. In there you will find 3 wires, and I'm not going to take them all out, but you will find all these various, 14 push pins, clear plastic with the metal tips, and also somewhere at the very bottom are quite a few rubber bands. However, I always like to add to these supplies, and I always carry around the little Ziploc bag with more rubber bands and with thumbtacks and more push pins. But bottom line, it comes with a board like this, plain and simple, has a cylindrical tube that contains the 3 wires, 14 push pins, and several rubber bands. And as I mentioned, I use all kinds of different things. The colored push pins, I use yarn, various things that I add to this, and you can do the same. The first graphic aid for mathematics that I showed you looked different from this one. This is a little bit older version, so in case you have one of these in your closet already, just wanted to let you know that this is still a graphic aid for mathematics. However, this time, instead of being rubber all the way around the outside, it has a wooden frame. And I've just shown you a little bit about how you might use this for some basic geometric figures, where we have the square and the rectangle and a pentagon. Bottom line, you put the push pins in wherever you want them and take a rubber band and you have outlined your geometric figure. This is something that one might use at the very basic elementary level for all types of things. I have not used the wires on this particular board, but again, I've used the push pins and the rubber bands that actually came with the graphic aid for mathematics. And finally, I'm actually going to show you one of the oldest versions of the graphic aid for mathematics. It still has a wood frame, but the wood is a little bit different. And then what I've done is I've gone ahead and taken my rubber bands, and I want you to know that this is not one long rubber band. It is, I think, 3 that I've hooked together and made the x-axis, which goes across, and the y-axis, which is the vertical axis. And then I have very colorful push pins because this board ran out of its push pins that came with it a long time ago. So I just have regular colored push pins that you buy wherever, and I've also attached some rubber bands in the upper right-hand corner for students to use. And like I said, this is a very old graphic aid for mathematics, and I'm going to stop saying graphic aid for mathematics because all of us just call this the graph board. So in the future you'll probably be hearing me refer to this as the graph board. This is one of the oldest tools that one would consider having universal design. It can be used with students who are totally blind, it can be used with students who have some vision, and it can be used with students who are deafblind. In fact, Originally, when I first got these boards out and worked with my students, I just used them on the students who were Braille readers, and all of my low vision students clamored and said they wanted to use it as well because they felt that this was much more fun and exciting. And over these 30 years that I've been teaching, I have found that low vision students seem to learn their graphing much better when using this particular graph board, not only because it's visual, but it also is tactile, and having that dual modality, not going to be able to explain it other than anecdotal to tell you that I see excellent results, that they really learn how to graph. And of course, it's the same for those students who have no vision at all or who are deafblind. And I really want my students to graph extensively, and they can do so incredibly fast on the graph board. In fact, I had a student one time who I was supposed to copy everything she did on the graph board onto a piece of graph paper, print graph paper, for her math teacher. And that student could graph faster on this than I could copy onto the print graph paper. So this is one of my absolute favorite tools. In addition, since it is such an old tool, I did receive a little flack about the fact that it was such an old tool, so I decided to bring it into the 21st century, and what I do for my students is I train them to take digital photos of what they have graphed, and you'll see a little more of that later. But anyway, it's pretty incredible that we've brought this very old tool, which, as I mentioned, does have that universal design in the sense that it is usable by just about everyone you can think of. Probably someone without the use of their hands wouldn't be able to use this, but it's very much usable by just about everyone else. So again, one of my very favorite tools, and I really want my students to graph and graph and graph, and this allows them to do so very quickly and accurately, and it's also usually they can, it's when as they're graphing, and I'll have to show you that later, it allows them, it's self-correcting. They can figure out if they've made a mistake. Again, I've just shown you three different versions of the graph board. If you have any of these, it's still the graphic aid for mathematics, which again I'm going to call the graph board. One thing I wanted to add additionally is that if you're using this, of course, in my class, my students would use it for a test or whatever, raise their hand, and I would check it right there during class time. But you're probably thinking, well, what about the regular ed math classroom and the regular ed math teacher? This is also very easily read by the math teacher, and they can also do a graph for their students. So it helps the student themselves do graphing independently, and the math teacher or a paraprofessional, whoever else might be assisting the student who has vision, will be able to see exactly what's going on as well. So that, I think that's it for right now.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Graphic Aid for Mathematics. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on Math for the Blind and Visually Impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Programs. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756 USA. Telephone, 512-454-8631. Website, www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009. All rights reserved.